Just Another Day. This is the last track.
Yeah, man. Play that New York
70s song. Again.
Show them how we do it. Downtown. Just another way to prove I love you when it's hard today. I'll lay
finally some fucking piano. Like it was lacking on this album, huh? Catchy melody again.
Oh, I could use some two or three or other kind of ways to be, but today I won't be so hard on me. I'll walk alone down a different street and smile at all the new strange I meet and pick up you.
Let's play this one really quick, and then I'll share my overall thoughts on the album and say my three favorite tracks from it. So this one, it alternates between two different chord progressions where the only one chord changes. So in the verse, it's... So it goes to the higher note, it goes... But then in the chorus, she goes lower instead, but that's the only chord that changes. The rest of it is the same with an additional one added in. And then again, the verse. Chorus. So, yeah. A lot of good melody in this album. A lot of good kind of traditional throwback music, I feel like. I definitely understand if people that love her pop music don't like this album basically at all. There were two or three tracks infused with a little bit of pop love there, but this was a more traditional instrument kind of album. And a really a way different sound than any of the other main Lady Gaga albums that I've reacted to. I really liked it a lot. I think the people in the YouTube comments that said I would love this album because I love A Star Is Born and I loved You and I were absolutely right. I kind of wish, it's weird. It's like, I kind of wish there was more pop infusion though. Like I think I'm finding I like them both together. I don't like the extreme pop and I don't necessarily like the extreme strip down because then I'm like, I can do that. I've got a guitar. Do the thing I can't do. Popify it. You know what I mean? Like. So I love the traditional instrumentation infused with the synth and the computerization. I think that that is a really cool sound and it takes you back to when you were younger and it makes you think of the future. It's just like a really good combination of sounds. And so I think based on that, I would say my three favorite tracks were probably, Perfect Illusion, I'm going to force myself to pick a top three. I did like this version of Joanne better than the acoustic one based on the feelings of my memory. But if I'm not mistaken, I think the three that I liked the most were the three with the videos. We're going to go with John Wayne, Perfect Illusion, and Million Reasons. I think those ones had that blend of kind of that pop sound that, again, I never used to like. But I'm, you know, she's won me over as a fan. So now I like that. Sound, especially from her, not necessarily everybody, but and I really love the traditional instruments, the guitar, the drums, the bass. I really loved the piano and keys that showed up finally at the end in Just Another Day. That was a really strong contender. That'd probably be number four. It was a really kind of simple song and a really short song, but it was effective. It was a good melody, I like the chords. So yeah, I would say John Wayne, Perfect Illusion and Million Reasons. But this is an almost just sit and play album. I'm not sure if there were tracks that I would skip a ton. Maybe Sinner's Prayer. I really liked Come to Mama. I liked Hey Girl as well. Angel Down. Ayo, which was kind of a weird one. And then all the way back to Diamond Heart, getting an introduction to the sound of this album. I think this is a really strong album. It's just as strong as anything else that she's done. I feel like it's maybe not as popular. Because I'd never even heard of any of these songs until I checked out the album and until people told me to check out the Joanne album. I didn't even know she released an album named Joanne, but I had heard of, I mean, I'd heard of songs like Poker Face and Paparazzi and Bad Romance, whatever. Like, I had at least heard of those songs, even if I never listened to them start to finish or saw their videos or whatever. This was completely off my radar. I didn't even know it existed. So, but it does explain quite a bit why she was able to help be persuaded or be in contention for the Star Is Born gig, because this is definitely the sound. And boy, do I love the music from A Star Is Born. I'm trying to figure out a way to come up with reactions. Maybe there's live performances I haven't seen. There are some tracks that I think are on the soundtrack that didn't make it into the movie that I haven't heard. So I do hope to react to those as well. If you liked this full album reaction, if you watched it in its entirety on Patreon, thank you so much for being here. Comment on the video and let me know your thoughts. If you watched this in the future on YouTube as I released the tracks that I was able to release without any copyright issues, thank you for watching. Make sure you like the video and subscribe. Comment on the YouTube videos as well. Let me know your thoughts on the individual tracks, on the album as a whole, and what else you want to see me react to. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.